Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, fellow inductees, and the new inductees, to Charlie, to Tom, and to Marlene. I'm very fortunate to be here tonight to introduce a dear friend of mine who I've known since 1976. He's been the Arnold Palmer of Japanese golf, as far as I'm concerned, in that country for almost four decades now. He epitomizes what the true spirit of international golf is all about. He epitomizes the fact that he wanted to chase his dreams of playing golf on a global basis. He epitomizes the fact that to do that, he had to leave his home shores. And believe me, of all the players who play professional golf, and Gary Player is the first one to really instill this, to travel from your home shores is not an easy task. But just think about it. When you travel from Japan and you come into the Western world, a different culture, different people, different language, different food, and believe me, they don't have mattresses over there. They have those tatami house style, and you sleep on the bamboo mats. So it was a total different change for Isao Aoki to chase his dream. But he did a tremendous job with that. He did it with gusto. He did it flying the Japanese flag wherever he went. And he did it with that weird putting stroke. I never forget the first time I ever went to Japan. All I read about was Aoki, Aoki, Aoki. And I'd never met Isao, but I was looking forward to playing with him, competing with him, because he was the king of Japanese golf at that time, and I wanted to get up in Japan and test my skills against the best that I could test. So I was intrigued to see how this wonderful putting stroke would work with the chopping action. I quickly learned that, and as Gary can attest, when you go to putt on these wonderful Korai greens in Japan back in the 70s, that you needed to have that chopping action. And Isao had a unique talent of beating all of us at his given skill. But along his side for four decades was his wife, Chie. Chie has been a tremendous supporter. She's been loyal. She's been there every step of the way. And when you think about four decades of travel and leaving your home country and not having a place anywhere else in the world to go to, believe me, they travel with plenty of suitcases. And I know along the way in recent times, Joanne's been there with him, watching him win, watching him perform, watching him promote the game of golf on a global basis. But one of the unique parts about Isao, when we used to invite him to come over to the house, and we still invite him to come over to the house for dinner, in some of those suitcases were their cooking utensils. Because they do favor the Japanese style of eating and their food. And every time we invited them over to our house, up comes two cars, one with the guys, Isao, Chie, sometimes Joanne, and his entourage of people to help him out, interpreters, even though Isao, believe me, speaks a little bit better English than I can speak Japanese. But anyway, the unique part about it was they bring out all their own cooking utensils, they bring the sushi, they bring the Kobe beef, they bring everything with them. All I had to do was supply the sake and the beer. It was a great trade-off. But our relationship really was forged, and my relationship with my wife and Chie was forged because we travel so much, because we get together in different places around the world. I know Chie's looked after my wife, Laura, every time that she's gone over to Japan and travel in that part of the world. But when I think back to Isao Aoki, what he did back when he won the Hawaiian Open, holding that pitching wedge, I believe, was from about 123 yards. Believe me, I know what that's like being done to me, so I was so pleased in those days to see Isao Aoki do it for his first victory in the Hawaiian Open. But what Isao Aoki did at that time was he created a mass exodus of Japanese golfers to the Western world. And today, nowadays, we see three Japanese players on the PGA Tour and three Japanese players on the Senior or Champions Tour. And that is a credit to Isao. That is a credit for him breaking the barriers of wanting to travel, and that's a credit to him for breaking the barriers to want to chase his dreams in the foreign land. And it's a pleasure to call him a friend, and as I call him a friend, I want us to go and take a quick clip and a video of Isao Aoki. Thank you.
Isao's legacy is his putting style. I mean, I never saw a putting style like that in my life. Most of the old pros used to jab the ball, but he's the king of the jabbers.
Yes, he has.
He had great hands. The club was always moving, and he was looking at the hole and looking back and moving all the time. And Isao was a great fighter.
That's it, in the hole!
He's proven himself not only a winner on the regular tour, he's won on the Champions Tour, he's won in Asia, he's won all over the world.
Isao has been a great player. What a touch, what a putter.
Another birdie for Aoki.
He's a great ambassador for Japan, a great ambassador to the game.
Aoki took his game outside, and I think he was very influential in all the modern-day Japanese players. They've just gotten better and better since he started playing and winning outside his country.
Certainly across the world, and in Japan, he is the Arnold Palmer of Japan.
Aoki is certainly one of the very strong golfing talents of the world. He has played so well in the United States and in Japan over the years. He is certainly a Japanese national hero.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce a good friend of mine, winner of 73 victories, tournament victories around the world, a great chef, a great friend, Isao Aoki.
Greg, thank you very much for flying to be my presenter and kind introduction. The first time Greg and I play in the state together was at the World Series in 1981. Since then, we've been good friend. Thank you again, Greg. I would like to tell you it is my great honor to be here, to be inducted to the Hall of Fame, and to meet all of you here tonight, including my friends from Japan and family. Golf gave me so many wonderful moments. To my life, I feel so rewarded and fortunate. I'd like to finish my speech in English, but tonight let me speak in Japanese, and I think I can express myself better.私がゴルフを始めたのは1950年代半ばで、15歳の時でした。中学生の時アルバイトキャディをして、ゴルフというスポーツを知り、学校を卒業したらプロゴルファーになろうと決めたからです。 トーナメントで優勝すれば賞金がもらえるし、ワールドカップに日本の代表選手になれば外国にも行ける。 貧しい農家に生まれた私にとって広い世界を自分の目で見たいというのは大きな夢でした。
I started playing golf when I was 15 years old in the mid-50s. I worked as a caddy when I was in junior high. I decided to become a professional golfer as soon as I finished school. If I won, I could make some money. I could even travel to play in foreign countries if I could make the World Cup team. I was born into a poor farming family, and therefore, that was my dream to see the world.
決して全てが順調にいったわけではありませんが、幸いに私は世界中のツアーでプレーする機会が恵まれ、そのいくつかのトーナメントで優勝することもできました。日本の国を離れ、外国に出て感じたことは、とにかく大きいの一言です。とにかくアメリカでは、国の広さも、ゴルフ場も、人の体も考え方も、すべての面で、私の育った日本には、なかったスケールの大きさを実感させられました。
In the beginning, it was not a smooth ride, but I was lucky to have opportunities to play on different tours in many different countries. And I was lucky to win some of them. The first thing I felt when I traveled abroad was everything was big. Especially in the States, the country itself, golf courses, people and ideas, everything.I never felt such magnitude while growing up in Japan.
1980年、バルタスロールの US オープンで、私は自分のゴルフ人生の中でも最高なプレーをしました。ジャック・ニクラウスと4日間同じ組でプレーし、私はひたすらチャンスを待ちました。どんなに完璧なゴルファーでも4日間72ホールのうちには必ず隙を見せる時が来ると確信していました。しかしジャックは一度も付け入る隙を見せてくれませんでした。ジャックのゴルフに驚くと同時に、私は自分の常識を超える選手のいる世界の広さを痛感しました。この時の経験は83年のハワイオープンの優勝、さらにチャンピオンツアーでも生きています。
I played what I consider to be my best game at the US Open at Baltusrol in 1980. I was paired with Jack Nicklaus for 4 days and I was waiting for my chance. I kept telling myself, no matter how perfect he is, he will make a mistake in 72 holes.In 4 days. But I was wrong. Jack did not make any errors until the end of the tournament. The level of his game astonished me, and at the same time, this was the first time I realized there was a player in the world who could play far better than my imagination. I must say that experience eventually led me to my first victory.At Hawaiian Open in 1983 and to the Champions Tour.
JPGA のテストを通ったのは21歳。トーナメントの初優勝が28歳と、私はデビューの遅いタイプのゴルファーでした。キングオブゴルフのアーノルド・パーム、ゲイリー・プレイヤー、そして私とほぼ同じ世代のジャック・ニクラウス、リー・トレビノ、レイ・フロイドといったプレイヤーたちは、私にとってまだキャディーをしていた時代にテレビで見ていた憧れの存在でしかありませんでした。自分とはかけ離れた世界にいたスーパースターたちと同じフィールドでプレーできる時代が来るとは、あのプロゴルファーを目指して修行していた少年時代には夢にも思いませんでした。
I passed JPGA test, equivalent to Q school here, when I was 21. My first victory came at the age 28. I was a late starter. Back then, I was a caddy watching TV in Japan and admiring Arnold Palmer, the king of golf, and Gary Player. Jack Nicklaus, Lee Trevino, and Ray Floyd, they were all from my age group. But they were my idols. While training to be a professional golfer, I never thought that I could play with superstars in the same field.
50 歳になってシニアのツアーに初めて参加したとき、私はレギュラー時代に戦った選手が再会を本当に喜んでくれ、私を仲間の一員として迎え入れてくれたことは私にとって生涯忘れられない思い出です。そして自分が PGA の一員でいられたことを最高に嬉しく思いました。そのチャンピオンツアーで9回も優勝できたのは自分でも信じられないくらいです。
When I turned 50 and participated in the senior event for the first time, many players welcomed me as a member of their group. What a wonderful and heartwarming memory that was. Having been on the PGA Tour helped me a great deal for the smooth transition to the Champions Tour. It is incredible that I won 9 tournaments on such a prestigious tour.
私には心から感謝を捧げたい人たちが大勢います。いつも私を励ましてくれた世界中のゴルフファンの方、親切にしてくれた PGA ツアーの役員、各地のトーナメントボランティアの皆さん、報道関係の方々、そして自分を産んでくれた両親、また長い間私をサポートしてくれたアメリカンエクスプレスやダンロップ、国際工業、オービック社の方々の支えがあって今の自分があるのだと思っています。
There are so many people that I would like to thank. All my fans from all over the world who tirelessly supported me. Officials and everyone at PGA Tour who generously cared for me and supported me. All the volunteers at tournament sites, media people, and of course my parents.American Express and Dunlop Corporation for their long-time support, as well as Kokusai Kogyo and Obik Corporation. I could not be standing here today without your support.
中でも最大の理解者であり、献身的な努力を続けているのは私のワイフの知恵です。ゴルフさえしていればよかった私はスーツを着て、パーティーに顔を出したりするのは大の苦手で、嫌がる私を無理やり引っ張り出す彼女とはよく衝突しました。しかし振り返ってみると、そんなゴルフコース以外のツアー生活がトーナメントで自分の力を出すための大きな原動力となりました。
And the best supporter of all is my wife, Chie.We used to fight when she dragged me to parties, receptions, and various social occasions, forcing me to wear suits and tie, which are not my favorite attire. I did not care for those things. I was happy just playing golf. But come to think, such social life and experience, other than playing golf, gave me a different perspective and a motivation to play better.
サム・シニードは、この世で勝てないものは3つある。雷とベン・ホーガンと下りのパットだと言ったそうです。私にとっては下りのパットはさほど怖くはありませんが、ジャックとチエには未だ勝って勝てません。
サム・シニード once said, The three things I fear most in golf are lightning,Ben Hogan, and a downhill putt. I'm not so scared of a downhill putt. but I am still afraid of Jack and Chie.
I love you, Joy.
Last but not least, I would like to say thank you from the bottom of my heart to my daughter, Joanne, who endured while her parents were busy traveling and not able to be with her all the time.
本当にありがとうございました。 Thank you very much.